Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Enigma of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Chapter 1. The Discovery. Dr. Elias Farid, an archaeologist renowned for his expertise in ancient Mesopotamian civilizations, was poring over aged texts and artifacts in the dimly lit archives of the Baghdad Museum. His eyes, reflecting a blend of fatigue and determination, skimmed through a pile of ancient manuscripts, each holding tales and secrets of a time long past. It was in this quiet corner of the museum, amid the scent of old parchment and dust, that Dr. Farid's life's work took a dramatic turn. His fingers, accustomed to the delicate handling of ancient relics, came upon a fragmented manuscript that seemed to hum with historical significance. The manuscript, partially damaged and worn by time, contained a series of inscriptions and drawings that hinted at the existence of one of the ancient world's most enigmatic wonders, the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. For centuries, the Hanging Gardens had been a subject of debate among historians and archaeologists. Described by ancient Greek historians like Strabo and Philo of Byzantium, the gardens were said to be a marvel of architecture and horticulture, a colossal structure of lush greenery ascending skyward in the heart of ancient Babylon. Yet, no concrete archaeological evidence had ever been found to confirm their existence, leading many to believe that they were nothing more than a myth. But the manuscript Dr. Farid had uncovered told a different story. The inscriptions, written in a blend of Akkadian and ancient Babylonian, described a garden of breathtaking splendor, with terraces reaching towards the heavens, irrigated by an intricate system of aqueducts and water wheels. The drawings, although faded, depicted terraces laden with a variety of flora, waterways, and structures that suggested a grand engineering feat. Excited by the potential significance of his discovery, Dr. Farid embarked on a journey to unravel the truth behind the ancient manuscript. He knew that confirming the existence of the Hanging Gardens would not only be a groundbreaking achievement in the field of archaeology but also shed new light on the technological and cultural advancements of the ancient Mesopotamian civilization. Assembling a team of experts, including historians specializing in ancient Mesopotamia, architects familiar with Babylonian construction techniques, and linguists skilled in ancient languages, Dr. Farid prepared for an expedition to the ruins of Babylon. The site, located about 85 kilometers south of Baghdad, had been the subject of numerous archaeological digs, but Dr. Farid believed that previous explorations might have overlooked crucial evidence. The team arrived at the ruins armed with the latest in archaeological technology, including ground-penetrating radar and advanced imaging equipment. Their task was daunting: to comb through the vast, sun-baked expanse of the ancient city, searching for any trace of the legendary gardens. As they began their meticulous survey of the site, Dr. Farid and his team focused on areas that had been largely unexplored in previous excavations. They were particularly interested in regions that, according to the manuscript, aligned with the described location of the gardens. The early days of the expedition were marked by intense heat and the challenging conditions of working in a desert landscape. But the team's spirits were buoyed by a series of promising findings. They uncovered a series of ancient foundations and structures that did not correspond to any known buildings in Babylon. These structures, located at a depth that suggested they were from the era of King Nebuchadnezzar II, the ruler often credited with building the gardens, provided the first hint that they were on the right track. The real breakthrough, however, came when they discovered remnants of what appeared to be an ancient irrigation system. This system, comprising a network of channels and basins, was consistent with ancient descriptions of the methods used to water the hanging gardens. The discovery suggested that the Babylonians had developed a sophisticated method to transport water from the Euphrates River to the gardens, a feat of engineering that was far ahead of its time. As the excavation continued, the team unearthed a variety of artifacts that offered glimpses into the daily life of ancient Babylon. Pottery shards, tools, and fragments of bas-relief sculptures were carefully cataloged and analyzed. Each artifact added a piece to the puzzle, helping to construct a picture of a civilization that was both advanced and deeply attuned to the aesthetics of their environment. For Dr. Farid, each day on the dig brought a mix of anticipation and awe. The possibility of uncovering one of the ancient world's greatest wonders was within reach. The fragments of the manuscript that had set him on this journey were proving to be more than just idle speculation. They were a map leading to one of history's most magnificent treasures. The story of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, a marvel that had captivated the imagination of historians and the public alike, was slowly unfolding beneath their hands. The expedition, initially sparked by the discovery of an obscure manuscript in a Baghdad museum, was on the verge of rewriting history, revealing the truths behind a legend that had stood the test of time. Chapter 2. Unveiling the Past. In the heat of the Mesopotamian sun, the ruins of ancient Babylon sprawled before Dr. Elias Farid and his team, an open book of history waiting to be read. The team, a blend of expertise from various fields, shared a common goal: to unravel the mystery of the Hanging Gardens, one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. Their days at the site were long and grueling. The team methodically excavated areas identified as potential sites of the gardens, sifting through layers of history. Each layer peeled back revealed more about the daily life of ancient Babylon, a city renowned for its architectural grandeur and cultural sophistication. One of the team's early and significant findings was the remnants of what appeared to be an elaborate irrigation system. The system consisted of a network of channels and basins, some of which were surprisingly intact. This discovery provided a tangible link to historical accounts of the gardens, which described a complex method of watering the plants and trees that adorned the terraces. As the excavation continued, Dr. Farid and his team discovered the foundations of a large structure. The layout and scale suggested that it could have been part of the gardens. The architecture bore the hallmarks of Nebuchadnezzar II's reign, characterized by grandiose construction projects and advancements in engineering. The team unearthed fragments of bas-relief artworks, some depicting trees and plants in a stylized manner, echoing the descriptions of the gardens from ancient texts. These artworks offered a glimpse into the aesthetic sensibilities of the Babylonians and their reverence for nature and green spaces. In addition to the physical remnants, the team found several cuneiform tablets in the vicinity. These tablets, once translated, provided accounts of construction projects under Nebuchadnezzar II's rule, including references to a grand garden. While the tablets did not explicitly mention the hanging gardens, the timing and nature of the projects described aligned closely with the period during which the gardens were said to have been built. One of the most intriguing finds was a series of tablets that appeared to be administrative records related to the allocation of resources for large-scale construction projects. Among these records were lists of plants, trees, and exotic flora, many of which required significant amounts of water, further supporting the theory of an advanced irrigation system. The excavation also revealed evidence of trading activities with distant lands. The team discovered pottery and artifacts that originated from as far away as the Mediterranean and the Indus Valley, indicating that Babylon was a cosmopolitan hub connected to a vast trade network. The combination of architectural remnants, artworks, and written records painted a picture of a society that was capable of creating something as extraordinary as the Hanging Gardens. The Babylonians' mastery of architecture and their ability to cultivate a lush garden in the harsh, arid climate of Mesopotamia were becoming increasingly evident. As weeks turned into months, the puzzle began to piece together. The findings suggested that the Hanging Gardens were more than a myth, they were a testament to the ingenuity and ambition of Nebuchadnezzar II's Babylon. Each discovery fueled the team's determination to continue their work, despite the challenging conditions. The sense of standing at the cusp of a significant historical discovery was a constant source of motivation for Dr. Farid and his colleagues. As they delved deeper into the heart of ancient Babylon, uncovering layer upon layer of the past, the story of the Hanging Gardens began to emerge from the realm of legend into the light of historical fact. The team's work was not only uncovering the secrets of one of the world's greatest wonders, but also bringing to life a civilization that had shaped the course of human history. For Dr. Farid, the expedition was a culmination of a lifetime dedicated to uncovering the secrets of the ancient world. Each artifact, each fragment of a tablet, each architectural remnant was a piece of a historical tapestry that he had been weaving together in his mind since the day he first read about the fabled gardens in his youth. The mystery of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, a marvel that had intrigued scholars and dreamers for centuries, was slowly yielding its secrets to those patient and persistent enough to seek them out. The sands of time were being pushed aside to reveal a chapter of human history that was as rich and vibrant as the gardens themselves. Chapter 3. Deciphering Ancient Secrets. In the shadow of the towering ruins of Babylon, Dr. Elias Farid and his team set up a makeshift laboratory where every artifact and tablet unearthed was meticulously examined. The key discovery of the stone tablet inscribed with cuneiform script became the focal point of their investigation. The tablet, aged and brittle, was carefully cleaned and preserved. Layla, an expert in ancient languages, took the lead in deciphering the script. The cuneiform was dense and complex, indicative of a high level of sophistication in writing during Nebuchadnezzar II's reign. After weeks of painstaking work, Layla began to unravel the script's mysteries. The tablet provided a detailed account of the construction of a grand edifice, a structure that bore striking resemblances to the descriptions of the Hanging Gardens. It spoke of a series of terraces, lush with exotic flora, and a sophisticated irrigation system that defied the arid conditions of the region. The text even mentioned the use of a unique type of machinery, possibly an early form of a screw pump, to transport water from the Euphrates River to the terraces. This discovery was a significant breakthrough. It was the first concrete archaeological evidence that supported the existence of the Hanging Gardens. The tablet also offered insights into the engineering prowess of the Babylonians and their deep understanding of horticulture. Emboldened by this discovery, the team intensified their excavation efforts. They unearthed further remnants of the terrace structures, with layers of reeds, bricks, and lead sheets that would have been used for waterproofing. This finding corroborated the tablet's description and suggested a level of architectural sophistication necessary to support a massive, elevated garden. As the team dug deeper, they uncovered the remains of what appeared to be the base of a large water reservoir. Near this structure, they found a series of clay pipes and bronze fittings, which were likely part of the irrigation system mentioned in the tablet. Dr. Farid hypothesized that the gardens were not only a display of beauty and power, but also a symbol of the Babylonian king's ability to harness and control nature. The gardens, in their grandeur and complexity, were a testament to Nebuchadnezzar II's ambition to create an oasis in the desert. The team's findings caught the attention of the global archaeological community. Scholars and historians from around the world began to arrive at the site, eager to witness the discovery that was reshaping understanding of one of the ancient world's most enigmatic wonders. In addition to the physical structures, the team discovered several artifacts that offered a glimpse into the daily life of those who tended to the gardens. Tools used for gardening, fragments of pottery used for transporting plants, and even seeds that had somehow survived the passage of time were found. These artifacts painted a picture of a bustling, living space where gardeners and workers might have spent their days tending to the exotic flora. The discovery of a small collection of personal items, including a ring with an inscription, a small statuette of a deity associated with fertility and agriculture, and a set of carved stones that were likely used for religious rituals, provided a more intimate connection to the people who lived and worked in and around the gardens. As the excavation season drew to a close, the team had gathered enough evidence to paint a vivid picture of the Hanging Gardens. They were not just a mythical representation of paradise, but a real, functional, and majestic structure that exemplified the advanced engineering and architectural capabilities of the ancient Babylonians. Dr. Farid and his team, through their meticulous work, had brought to light a marvel of the ancient world. The Hanging Gardens of Babylon, long shrouded in mystery and legend, were now a tangible part of history. Their discovery not only answered centuries-old questions, but also opened new avenues of inquiry into the capabilities and achievements of ancient civilizations. The story of the Hanging Gardens, once hidden beneath the sands of time, was now being told anew, a narrative of human ingenuity and the timeless quest to create beauty and wonder in the midst of a challenging environment. Chapter 4. Revealing the Wonder. The revelation of the Hanging Gardens remains was a momentous occasion in the world of archaeology, a culmination of Dr. Elias Farid's tireless pursuit and his team's dedication. As they stood amidst the ruins of what was once one of the greatest wonders of the ancient world, there was a sense of awe and a deep respect for the ingenuity of the Babylonians. The excavation site, now bustling with activity and excitement, had drawn scholars, historians, and tourists from across the globe. Dr. Farid, with his team, had meticulously uncovered and reconstructed the layout of the gardens, revealing the grandeur of the terrace structure. The reconstructed terraces rose majestically, with evidence of the sophisticated irrigation system that had sustained them. The team had unearthed remnants of the archaic pumping technology, which was believed to have lifted water from the Euphrates River to the topmost terrace. This system was a marvel of engineering, showcasing the advanced understanding of hydraulics and architecture possessed by the Babylonians. The detailed bas-relief artworks and sculptures found at the site depicted a lush, verdant oasis, teeming with a variety of plants and trees, some of which were exotic and not native to the region. This suggested that the Babylonians not only mastered irrigation techniques, but were also skilled in horticulture and botany. Among the most significant finds was a series of clay tablets that were unearthed near the base of the main terrace. These tablets, once translated, revealed detailed accounts of the construction and maintenance of the gardens. They contained records of the different types of plants cultivated, the daily routines of the gardeners, and notes on the architectural modifications made over the years. This discovery provided a rare glimpse into the daily operations of the gardens and underscored their significance in Babylonian culture. The gardens were not merely an architectural wonder, but also a center of botanical study and a symbol of the king's power and his ability to create life in the harsh desert environment. Dr. Farid and his team also discovered evidence of an extensive network of trade routes that connected Babylon with distant lands. These routes were used to procure the exotic plants and trees that adorned the gardens, as well as the materials used in their construction. This finding highlighted the cosmopolitan nature of Babylon under Nebuchadnezzar II's rule and its connections with the wider ancient world. The excavation revealed more than just the physical structure of the gardens, it brought to life the stories of the people who built and maintained them. The artifacts and records painted a picture of a society that valued beauty, nature, and innovation. The gardeners, architects, and laborers who worked on the gardens were part of a grand project that transcended generations. As the excavation drew to a close, Dr. Farid organized a symposium at the site, inviting experts from around the world to discuss the findings and their implications. The symposium was a celebration of the discovery and a forum for planning future research and preservation efforts. The revelation of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon was a milestone in archaeological history. It reshaped the understanding of one of the ancient world's most enigmatic wonders and provided new insights into the technological and cultural achievements of the Babylonian civilization. For Dr. Farid, the discovery was the fulfillment of a lifelong dream. He had not only uncovered a wonder of the ancient world, but had also brought to light the ingenuity and spirit of a civilization long gone. The Hanging Gardens, once a legend, were now a testament to humanity's enduring desire to create, innovate, and reach for the sublime. The Hanging Gardens of Babylon, a marvel that had captivated imaginations for centuries, had been brought back to life, revealing the timeless allure and mystery of the ancient world.